it's important that we understand that we must now begin to place emphasis on the new emerging kingdom apostolic structures that need to be built, right? Because I'm going to show you something from the things that God inspired to be built in the Old Testament and how they speak to the things that God will have us do in the New Testament. So let's look at Solomon's temple. Solomon's temple was a static temple, right? I think when I began, I asked the question, is God still in the business of inspiring us to build mega structures? Do we need them? I think I've answered that question now. We need them because they serve as physical gathering places and equipping centers, right? Do we need them? Yes, we do need them. Do they have to be static? Let me get to that now. Solomon built the temple. The temple was a static temple. It was a temple that was static and was at one point. And so everyone from wherever they were came to Solomon's temple. Fellowship and sacrifices and everything happened there. However, let's go back to previous structures that have been built. And let's see if they were static or they were mobile. Noah, for instance, the Bible makes us to understand that Noah, by interaction with heaven, had received schematics for building a physical structure that was going to carry out God's mandate in the earth. A flood was going to come. People were going to be destroyed. And lives were going to be destroyed by the flood. However, God sought to create an opportunity for people to be saved, as many as will believe. Same way we understand that as many as believed in Christ will not perish but have everlasting life. So you see, God is still in that business of creating structures that saves life. God was in that business in the time of Noah. So he instructed Noah, and Noah moved by faith, with fear, with holy reverence, to the building of an ark, and also to the saving of his family. Those who believed, those who worked with Noah, his family basically, were saved. Of course, and the animals. But those who did not believe, who laughed at Noah, who laughed him to scorn, they died in the flood. They died in the flood. So you see, Noah built that ark. And that ark, that building, was responsible for the saving of lives, was also responsible for even the saving of animals. And I keep telling people that, listen, the animals going extinct, the stopping of animals going extinct, they answer lies with the church. It is not now there was a threat on the lives of animals, and the threat on their lives and certain animals going extinct. Even in that time, animals could have gone extinct. But you see, the ark that Noah had built was responsible for the saving of the lives of animals, ensuring that they do not go extinct. We must understand that. And so we must understand that the wisdom of God is going to be at work in creative, skilled people to the building of things that goes beyond even just the saving of human life, but also to the saving of animals. It is not just left to the scientists and some crazy people who love animals more than they should. No, it is the responsibility of the church also to play a role in preserving society, because the creation waits for the manifestation of the sons of God. It did not say sinful men or suffering people. It said creation waits for the manifestation of the sons of God. Creation waits for the sons of God to ascend to their real estate in God and begin to come with inventions, bring inventions to the earth that will save, that will sustain, that will stop the destruction that we see. However, if that doesn't happen, we will continue to see destruction. And so Noah built this ark that saved animals and saved his family. But note this, the ark was not a static, stationary, a stationed structure. The ark was a mobile structure, because that same flood that came and destroyed many lifted up the ark, and the ark was in motion. So you see, it is not only static structures that God inspires us to build. And all along, we it is okay, and I've established that we need physical structures. We've been building physical structures. However, God will have us build mobile structures too.